Hi friends, I am Jitendra Bafna. Today we will going to see Data Weave Transformation Part 4. In this session, we will going to see a map operator, how, why we require the map operator in Data Weave Transformation, first thing. And then after that, we will see some, you know, inbuilt functions which are available with a Data Weave Transformation. Okay, so like split by, replace, how can you use, you know, capitalize. Okay, so various functions we will going to see. Okay. So let me start. So first let me start with creating new application file, new Mule project, DW4 app, Mule runtime. I will keep 3.8 only. Rest of the setting I will not going to touch. The one thing, like in your run, there can be multiple runtime in your environment. You can choose depending on your requirement. I will say finish. First thing, I will drag and drop HTTP listener component. So into message canvas, under the connector configuration, I will click on this add button. I will keep rest of the setting default. I will not going to change anything. I will press on OK. Under the path, I can give DW4. Allow method, I will say post. Right. So next thing, I have a transform message. I will drag and drop transformation in the message processor. Then finally file. So file connector, where we will going to save our final output. So before that, configuring the file connector, I want one folder, output folder. I will say file, new folder, out, finish, transform message. Sorry, let me configure the path on the file connector. Source test resources slash out. Fine. Let me save it. What I will going to do, I will show you. This is my input message, okay, and let me open one more notepad and let me show the output. So this is my input and I want the output in this format. Okay, so you will come, so you will come to know like why we want to use a map operator. So let me first start mapping into transformation. So first thing, I will define the input message. I will say add, I will say in, create type, I'll select JSON, I'll select example, let me select the example, this is my example, I will just select. Now I will define my output metadata. I will say add, I'll click on this out, I will say create type, this is JSON, I'll say example, okay. I select my output metadata. Taking some time, let's wait. Let me clear the metadata. Let me define metadata again. Output, I will say JSON, I will say example, I will say desktop 2 on lang 1. Okay, so that is fine. It doesn't matter. Like, let me check what is the issue with output. Maybe okay. I have to maybe start with a curly bracket at the top. Okay, fine. Let me check it now. Define metadata, output folder. I will say JSON. Let's say example. I will go to desktop. Now you can see your output metadata. I will say select. Okay, let me remove this bracket. Okay, the first thing I will say ptense. I will say $. Okay, so I will say owner. Payload. Dot motor. Okay, now I will say categories. Payload dot type. If you see preview, but if you see like output is not required format, like your all owner is into the one array and all categories into the other array. We don't want like that, right? We want the output in this format. Who is the owner of book and who like that in this format. See Louis Miguel. Okay, what are the category related to my book? So I want in that format. So for that, what I have to do, okay, so I will say payload dot item map. Say map. Okay, instead of payload, I will use dollar here. I will remove this item. So you can see the output in better format, so in the required format by us, right? This is the output what we require. So that is the use of map operators. Okay, so it will properly, you know, like create a, it will do the proper mapping, like this is the owner and this is his category, this is owner, like that. Okay, previously what is happening, like it was creating the array for owner and the category for array one, category for category. So we don't require the output in components. That's why we have used the map operator. Let me test deploy the application and test it. Deployed the application. This is my input message. I'm going to send this. Okay, no listener for DW3, it's DW4. Okay, let me send it. Okay, so you get a 200. Okay, let me refresh it. In out folder you can see the file, the output file, right? This is the output file. Now we're going to see some other method also. First thing, like I will just open preview here. You just keep watching the preview. Okay, I will make it bigger. So if I say author split, I press split by space. See, you can see like it has been split, owner has been split, yeah, into Louis and first name and last name. So you can see the array for every place, Victoria, Romaria, all those things. Okay, this is first thing, this is the first function, like you can split also. Second thing, if you want to replace any value into the author, I will say replace, I will say I want to replace Louis. Okay, so I will use with whom, I will say with, this is Joel. So you can see Louis has been replaced by Joel. Okay, other thing, you know, here you can see book is a in a small letter, but if you want your first letter to be a capital, okay, so what you can do, there is a keyword called capitalize. Okay, so you can use that space. See, your first word has been capitalized. If you want, to make everything upper, so you can use the upper function. See, everything has been converted into upper. Similarly, we have a lower, so everything will be converted into lower. See, instead of book, you want books. So there is a function called pluralize. So let me. It will automatically, you know, pluralize your function. Similarly, we have a singularize. Okay, so let me show you. You can see now it's become book, right? So there are various, you know, inbuilt function available with MuleUSB. You can make use of those function. So you now you come to know like what are the function, how to use the function in the data, in the data view mapping, and what is the use of map operator, right? Okay, so yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching video.